Mrs. Stiltskin.
You say you knew nothing of the stolen babies?
I knew nothing.
And you didn't suspect anything?
Not one little thing. Officer, my husband's always been an eccentric man. He's always been peculiar. I knew nothing different, you see.
Tell us what happened.
A month ago, he came home with a wriggling bundle in his arms. It wasn't the first time. He often returned with bundles. They usually held loaves of bread. He said it was bread. He took it into the other room. He had dinner with the children, lamb and potatoes, roasted in rosemary and butter. I make the best potatoes. Oh, and peas. From the garden, last of the season. Well, I heard some crying. He said it was the wind, but it didn't stop. I went into the room to check the window, and the baby was in a bowl on the bed sheets. I unfolded him. He was beautiful.
Where did Mr. Stiltskin say the baby came from?
He didn't. He was as surprised as I was. We named him Jacob. The other children loved him, of course. It was a blessing from the Lord.
A baby appears in your bed after your husband comes home with a bundle, and you believe he doesn't know where the baby came from?
The bundle was bread. Rye from the bakery down the street. We had it with dinner. The children ate so quickly. It's not easy for them, you know, with so many siblings.
Mrs. Stiltskin, isn't it possible your husband may have brought the baby with the bread?
He wouldn't have lied to me. Bread and a baby are not one and the same. The other children, they arrive the same way. The Lord smiles down on those who love him. I may look a little right, but I'm not stupid.
I never said you were, Mrs. Stiltskin. But why would the bread bundle move?
The bundle didn't move.
You said it did?
It didn't. Bread does not move.
Earlier, you said...
My husband left the bread with me in the kitchen. I didn't see a thing move.
He went straight to the kitchen.
Don't I deserve a son?
Of course you do.
Do you have children?
Two. Two girls. Precious.
Do you deserve them?
Deserve? It's not a question of deserve. They come whether you deserve them or not.
What would you have done then, if you and your missus, if you tried and tried? You were so in love, you tried. You wanted nothing more than a child. Physical manifestation of that love. You tried and you failed. You failed because your wife, she was as dried up as a rotten pumpkin. Your husband shriveled as a sun-dead worm. All this hypothetical, of course. But your house was so quiet, as if the quiet might deafen you. You weren't even sure you could hear anymore, so quiet. And your wife's belly lay as flat as a flapjack. And you deserved it. Boy, did you deserve it. You've been in love long enough to have this. Hypothetical. What would you have done?
Me? I don't know. What would I have done? It's an impossible question. It didn't happen to me that way. How could I know?
And then a girl, too young to have what you deserve, too lazy. Would she take care of him? Of course not. She can't even spin straw into gold. You'd be surprised how many girls like this there are, stuck in impossible situations. And what do they do about it? They cry and moan. They sit and dream of silk they will never have when they should be trying, at least not ambitious even, to try. She agrees. She offers the child all for a kingdom. She'll give a child for a castle. Would you take it? Would you save a poor child crying in the street? How is it different?
Of course I would save a child on the street. If I had to, of course. Officer's honor, I would save a child in need, but...
Then you know what it's like to want a child so bad you have to steal for it.
I know. I mean, I think I understand. I see what it must have been like. But Mrs. Stiltskin, we can't just let you go. We have to return the children to their rightful parents.
Children are mine. Boy is mine.
The children are yours? Don't cry. Perhaps they are. The children, Mrs. Stiltskin, perhaps they are yours. But they are someone else's too. Please, we do what we have to. We have to return them. They belong with their real parents.
I am their real parent. They were mine since we found them in the bedsheets, gifts from God. The boy, he fit right in the space we left for him, right down in the crib, his little head against the pillow, his arms clutching at the bare eyes sewed for him. Jacob Stiltskin. He has his father's nose, you know, and he'll grow into a fine little lad. He is safe. He's been ours all along. Our little bundle of bread.